everybody, A-Spec here, and this is yet another iRobot product on my channel, the iRobot Braava 380T. And the T stands for turbocharger. And no, this is not a performance upgrade, as you might be thinking. This is a high-capacity, high-performance charging system used to let the battery attain its full capacity in a matter of approximately an hour, rather than 4 hours. And this device comes with the North Star Navigation Cube, which is basically a GPS system for your house. The way it works is it takes a picture of the ceiling. It looks around on the ceiling, it looks for edges of objects and edges of carpets and stuff like that, and it builds a map of the house. The robot doesn't do any of the mapping. The cube does the mapping. So I think why they did that is to provide the user with more convenience, as well as reducing the amount of heat output and heat dissipation capability the robot would need to have, because a robot powerful enough to do mapping on the fly would use much more power, generate much more heat, and possibly require some sort of heat sink to keep its processor cool. So this cube offloads some of the mapping grunt and the CPU grunt from the robot onto a cube, and then transmits the mapping data to the robot so it can make its way around the house in its most efficient path. Which, as you can see, it basically, it backs up, it moves forward, it backs up again, and then it moves forward again to the right. And as you can see, it just bumped into something. And that is normal. It uses those bumps pretty much like the Roomba does to figure out what's there, and the mapping system might, the cube might not have picked up. So it navigates around chair legs, table legs, stuff like that, stuff that the cube probably couldn't accurately determine with its bump sensor. And it also has a carpet sensor, which I believe is the same as the bump sensor. The bump sensor also uses tactile feedback to determine where the robot is and where the carpets are. And the North Star Navigation Cube is just designed to provide and produce a more accurate and more methodical cleaning pattern for the robot to follow. So you can put either dry or wet pads on this robot, and it has two modes, wet and dry. Wet is the cleaning pattern you're seeing right now. Dry, it'll just go in straight lines back and forth across the room. It's a lot faster, but it usually doesn't work as well with the wet pad, because this is how iRobot programmed it for the wet pad, and if you use the dry cleaning pattern of the wet pad, it doesn't get anywhere near the performance. So as you can see, this thing is just navigating its way around the chair legs. Seems... no... it's stuck. And it seems like it just is able to get the most possible cleaning out of every type of room you put it in, because of this cube.
I want to go more over here, so I'm looking.
Yeah, do not... that's another thing. Do not move the cube while it's cleaning.
Oh.
And that'll mess up the navigation.
Oh, okay.
So,
okay.
You better not move the cube. Any of you that may own a Braava, do not move the cube while it's cleaning. That'll mess it up.
Okay, let's do this thing.
Alright, my grandfather and I are going to take our trailer to consignment. So, be back in a while. Upload this video. Thanks for watching. This is A-Spec. He just came back from our trip to Camping World for the RV consignment. Our RV is now sold. And I just found Braava stuck underneath this chair, and I just moved it out, and now it's cleaning again. I don't know why it got stuck, and I have never seen it stuck in like 6 months of ownership of this device. I've never seen it stuck there before. Because it's usually pretty intelligent. It usually doesn't get stuck. So this concludes my review of the iRobot Braava 380T. Once again, this is A-Spec, signing out.